The founders are back, well, at least some of them, in this season of Picard. As always, I'm Al, this is the Geek in Review, and in this video, I want to have a little chat about the founders, the changelings, whatever you want to call them, and probably the Vorta and the Jem'Hadar as well. But before we get into it, thanks for taking the time to watch this video, and please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. So yeah, the big bads from Deep Space Nine are back, and it was about time because I was never really satisfied with the sort of way that they tied up the Founders or the Changelings. I'm just going to call them the Founders at the end of Deep Space Nine because, you know, they just surrendered and then Odo went back to the Great Link and that was it. I always thought there'd be a bit more to this, and I think that's one of the reasons. I think the end of Deep Space Nine presented quite a few problems for the Star Trek universe, and I'll get into that later on in the video. But yeah, I think it's one of the reasons that New Trek hasn't really touched Deep Space Nine, or at least went into the stories or the characters or the lore or anything like that. But it looks as if this is all going to change with Picard, so I just want to talk about a few ideas and a few questions and a few theories that I have. So yeah, Deep Space Nine, that's what you think of when you think of the Founders and the Changelings, because, you know, Odo was one, and he was a main character for 7 seasons. Teased in Season 2, and then introduced in Season 3, the Changeling arc was essentially Deep Space Nine from Season 3 to Season 7, because the Dominion affected everything. So do I think we're going to go back to the Deep Space Nine station in Picard? Maybe. The reason I say maybe is we may see the station, but I don't physically think that the crew will go onto the station just for the whole cost of building sets. So they might pass by it, or at least it might very much get a mention. But we could also be going to Cardassia, because who else do you associate with the Dominion and the Alpha Quadrant but the Cardassians? And that's where we left them off at the end of Deep Space Nine. As far as we know, all the surviving members of the Dominion and the Alpha Quadrant were still in or around the Cardassian area. Plus, there's the fact that Worf was in both TNG, Deep Space Nine, and now Picard Season 3, so bringing back the Founders and the Dominion, they can tie in a lot to that character. So while I don't think we're going to get on the station, or maybe even see it, we could get a few familiar faces back. So, the strong possibilities, Kira, yep, Nana Visitor still looks as if she could be Kira. In fact, she's hardly aged, in my opinion, since the end of Deep Space Nine. She was the one left in charge and they've picked up her story here and there, but beyond that, we've never had any really solid information on what she got up to in live action Trek. Next choice would be Bashir. Again, the actor still looks the part. He was an absolute fan favourite, and he had the whole Section 31 thing going on, so God knows what Bashir got up to after Deep Space Nine. And if you think of Bashir, it's got to be O'Brien, because like Worf, he was in The Next Generation, and this would be an absolute fan favourite character and cameo to bring back. And if O'Brien doesn't show up, I can only assume it's because Colm Meaney doesn't want to do it, because it's such a great idea, the connective tissue between the shows like Worf, you get it. But who I think is most likely, well, Garrick. And I think he makes the most sense as, again, absolute fan favourite character. And we've got Worf, who was in TNG in Deep Space Nine, and Garrick was always a bit of an antagonist for Worf. And who else is going to be steeped in this whole conspiracy founder stuff? He's the perfect bridge from Cardassia, where we last seen him in Deep Space Nine, and a link to Worf and the Dominion. And again, everyone would love to see Andrew Robinson back in the role of Garrick, so I think there's a strong possibility if we see any face back, it'll be Garrick. But enough of the solids, let's talk about the Founders. So yeah, this is a sort of rebel fraction of the Great Link, as far as we're aware at the moment, according to Worf, who heard it from Odo. So I don't get how that works and how they rebel, because again, the Great Link was all about harmony and unity, not like the Borg, you know, that was sort of enforced unity. It was more consensus from the way that they described it in Deep Space Nine, at least that's how I picked it up. So how does this rebellion work, and why are they rebelling? We're going to need a lot of blanks filled in about what happened after the Dominion War, because again, Live Trek has not touched it at all, other than a very, very, and I do mean very slight reference. Is it something that Starfleet done to them after the war? Usually the losing side has to give reparations or there's some sort of punishment, so was something like that involved? And I think the reason that New Trek has stayed away from Deep Space Nine and the whole Dominion stuff is, as I mentioned at the start of the videos, it presents the Trek universe with some interesting problems. And that problem is, what do you do with the Jem'Hadar? Because yeah, they were great villains, and they had great arcs where the characters got developed and you found out that they weren't all mindless killing machines. But at the end of the day, Starfleet beat them. There's probably hundreds of thousands, if not millions of them. So if you beat these guys in a war, what do you do with them after that? You can't let them go, because that's too dangerous. You can't really imprison an entire race, because that wouldn't really work. You can't kill them. So yeah, the Jem'Hadar and the Dominion, I think, is the reason that Deep Space Nine hasn't been referenced as much as other Trek shows in the new iterations of Trek, because when you start going down the road of what happened after the Deep Space Nine finale, it would get a little bit murky. But I do want to see how Picard Season 3 handles this, because I think it's Episode 8 is called Dominion. So that's the one I think that's going to be most likely going to tie to Deep Space Nine or Cardassia in some way, shape or form. But not only do they need to let us know what happened after Deep Space Nine, they need to fill in some blanks in their own show. Why are these changelings after Jack, and why are the visions linked? Now, before Episode 4, I did think that once the changelings were revealed, we might see some new Starfleet tactics about stuff they'd learned about how to deal with or detect the Founders, because they were always at a huge disadvantage to them. And I'm kind of disappointed Episode 4 didn't add more to this than they've got a bucket if we find out we've got them. That, to me, didn't really make sense. Because in Deep Space Nine episodes, when they went back to Earth, you've seen that Starfleet was working on new ways to deter and detect Founders, so yeah, I'm not really happy about the way that they've handled it so far. So although we've not seen anything new from Starfleet, we have seen something new from the Founders themselves. And I mean that scene with Vadic in the hand. Now this has raised a lot of questions online. The main one being, is Vadic a changeling? Or is it just part of her arm that's a changeling? Because the way that you watch it, it could go either way. And yeah, while the new ability is cool, the fact that it was never mentioned at all in any of the shows that the changelings appeared in before is a little retconny, and I'm not sure how I feel about it. If they do it again or they overdo it, they'll need to explain it. Although I would say it does work for me that the fact that that's how changelings might communicate, but with Vadic in the arm, what's going on? Do you think that she's a full changeling, or do you just think it's part of her arm that's a changeling? Let me know in the comments below. And the new ability isn't the only change we're seeing in the Founders. I mentioned it in my review of Episode 4. As I mentioned earlier on in this video, the Great Link always seemed to be about consensus and debate, whereas the way that whatever Vadic was talking to, there's definitely a hierarchy and a command structure now, and she's near the bottom and it's at the top. So yeah, the changeling have sort of now gone back to a hierarchical structure, which to me doesn't make sense, because in Deep Space Nine, when the female changeling was explaining it to Odo, she always said that the solids infought and that would always be their undoing, would be their aggression. That's why the changelings wanted to control them. So, doesn't really work for me, but, you know, works for the episode, I suppose. And also, what was Vadic talking to? Was it one changeling? Was it the changeling? Was it just her handler in the way that Worf was Raffi's handler? Was it some sort of version of the Great Link, or some evil version of the Great Link? It was only a very short scene, and it did answer one question, kind of, but it raised about four or five other ones. So yeah, what do the Founders want, and why did they rebel, or at least a small group of them? Are we going to find out how many have rebelled and what they're up to? We're going to have to wait and see. How is it all tied to Picard, or at least Jack Crusher? We haven't found that out yet, and again, we don't know much about Picard and the Dominion War. Hell, we only just found out that he met Herosian, so he could have run up to anything. But has Picard had some sort of interaction with the Founders or the Dominion in the past that we're not aware of that's going to come back to haunt him? But yeah, what happened to the Vorta and the Jem'Hadar after the Dominion War? And all this stuff is reasons that New Trek hasn't touched Deep Space Nine, because it was so complex. And I'm kind of going to say so well written compared to most New Trek, not all. But yeah, where are the Jem'Hadar and the Vorta? They need to at least reference that and let us know. I'd also kind of like to know who's running Cardassia now and what that's like there. I don't think we're going to get too much, if anything, on any of this though. Like I say, I think most of it will be references. We may get a few actors show up in person or through a comm link. As always, we're going to have to wait and see. But what are your thoughts about the Founders being back? Do you like the new ability? What's going on with Vadic? And what's the end goal? And what did they steal from the Daystrom Institute? I want to hear your theories, as always, in the comments below, or you can reach out to me on Twitter at TheGeeksReviews. If you've made it this far, as always, thanks for watching and leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel.